Things is going to heat up around there, and we're going to bring you the best wrestling program anywhere, I'm telling you. And we're going to get our show on the way. That's it. Thank you very much. We're ready to start our show.
Show up tonight. Yeah, that's a tactic. It don't really matter. I don't need a partner. I'll take you both along and go on and turn myself.
I thought you don't have a partner.
Send him back with the DJ.
I'm from Columbia, Texas. Watch out, here I come.
Yeah. Yeah, y'all yell at
me. Yeah, I think I might see something. They might stay with the punch before.
Are you scared? Hanging on, Patch X. This match is a special challenge match and it's scheduled for one fall.
Yeah! Suddenly helped energize the team a little bit, but he picks up that fourth foul. Tennessee's down by 11, and the rest of the guys picked up the defensive pressure for slam the bench. We made the comment that the defense would get better than Slay went out, but the Slay was really tired. He wasn't able to play a lot of defense because of the foul trouble. Elgrace came in, and the defense really raised up. You can't send that back to Anchor on three. Now, he ended up getting a bunch of points. He got a lot of them at the end. He's a heck of a player. But he really didn't get loose much in the second half until right at the end. Higgins did a great job. CJ did a nice job getting the passing runs. Thaddeus Holding was everywhere. You know, he's deflecting balls. He stripped. One time he stripped the guard. Higgins comes up with the ball. I mean, they just make some good plays.
Making fun of me, as he always does. So I'd like Mr. Chris Michaels to come out right now.
Right? scary in the headline of group nine. I'm Chris Mack with another headline.
Big deal.
So it's like this. You're so good, you're so big, and you're so bad. Let's make this interesting. How about this? You put your, I'm not even asking your career, just if you lose tonight, you never come back. And I mean ever. You can't even buy a ticket to come into my show. So how about them apples? So if this mystery opponent beats me tonight, I gotta leave and never come back. I'll agree to that on one condition. No, it's real simple. If I beat your mystery opponent tonight, I get a title shot anytime I want. What's wrong with that? That's fair. So all you want is a title shot. And if you lose, when you lose, you're gone. I never have to see the headliner ever again. How about it, friends? All you want is a title shot. Anytime you want it.
It could be next week or next month.
Okay.
It's a... Let's say no.
Now, I'm good to my word. That's good enough right there. It's been awful cold, hasn't it, headliner? When you're cold at home, you like some coffee to warm you up. Do you? Well, how about some hot chocolate? You like hot chocolate? You like a hot chocolate with some marshmallows? And then just stick around. Stick around, Comet. Come on. surprise. You look as surprised as all of these new people here at the Grand Slam. Because this is a day in Columbia history, whether you know it or not, Chris Michaels. This is the first time that Hot Shot Recorded Wings has wrestled in Columbia for someone other than Burt Reynolds or Mike Foy. So this is special to me. Hey! Don't worry about him, worry about me. You see, the last time that I was in Columbia, I just had to be in this building. And not only was I in this building, not only was I in this building, I stood right here in the center of the Grand Slam with the NWA Mid-American Heavyweight title firmly around my waist. And I'm getting a little bit off the subject here, but that causes a problem for me, Chris. Because while I was NWA Mid-American Champion, Mike Porter seemed that, I don't know if it was jealousy amongst the boys, not to book Corey Williams anymore. The last time I was here was the last time I wrestled for the NWA. And he chose not to book me, and I was the heavyweight champion. Now he's got some jerk running around calling himself the Mid-America champion. He reminds me of you, how cocky he is. That boy can lace up my boots or carry my jockstrap, let alone the Mid-America title. And if anybody sees Mike Porter or Rex, whatever his name is, or anybody from NWA Main Event, tell him Hot Chocolate said that their champion ain't nothing. They got a problem with me? Mike Porter still has my phone number. But back to you. See that punk that's carrying that belt over there, a belt that's mine that I was never defeated for? You know, it kind of burns at me. And when I see guys, what am I thinking they or what they're not, makes me a little sick, Chris. And that's what you do. You think it's something you're not. You think you're the greatest showman that this business has ever seen. You think that you're the greatest professional wrestler this business has ever seen. You think you can do it all. Jeez, Chris. I've done everything you've done and more of it. The headliner of professional wrestling, you're talking former Mid-American champion, three-time North American tag champion, broadside champion, every tag team belt in this Tennessee, Kentucky, Alabama, Georgia area, and every single time I've had one. So what gives you the right to call yourself the headline? So if there's a headline in professional wrestling, and if there's a headline in the CWA, you're looking at it. The headline is none other than Hot Chocolate Corey Williams. So crawl back up in here.
Mickey!
You're gonna get your butt kicked.
Come on, Pop. Another part of the backside is going to be hurt once you get in the ring. Come on, Chippy.
Lakeisha, I'm going to ask you a favor. Let me announce this match tonight.
Hey, one time. Come on, Chris. Show us you the headline. Show us you're not the same Chris Michaels that was running around acting like the Red Roots on NWA TV years ago. I never know a headline to act like a chicken on TV. But you're acting like you're all right. Now, get in the ring, bro. But who's on the back?
You're gonna get your butt whipped. The following contest will end Chris Michaels' career at Grand Slam. In the corner, to my right, from Nashville, Tennessee, this is the Comet Chris Michaels.
You know my name.
And his opponent from Nashville, Tennessee.
Go, Corey, go! Go, Corey, go!
slain. His open handed. Yeah, absolutely.
Thank you.
I feel bad. We cheered for Corey. I'm going to mention your name in the cheer right now. Chris Michael sucks. Chris Michael sucks. Chris Michael sucks.
You're doing your job.
Mercy. You were signed in this match. I'm sorry, I'm the matchmaker here. You appointed me this duty, and I'm doing my job. He's trying to do his job. He's doing his, he's doing his. And that's what you got done to tonight. How that changed your life, I have no idea. You didn't tell me you weren't in a match. All these people in Columbia sat here and just told you I did not hit him with a chain, but you reversed the decision.
Tony, you're right. I put you in charge. And I said the referee's decision. But wait a minute. One thing I can't do, and you can't stop this. Roger, look at me. You're fired! I'm still fired. I can't change the match, right? And I'm fired.
By me holding the last legal singles victory over you,
That makes me number one contender, Chris. Think about it. Think about it, Chris. I see you before it's all over. I'm telling you, it's not easy doing the job I've been appointed to do. You should try, I'm telling you. You can't please everyone. I'm just trying to do what Nikki told me to do. I've got years of experience.
The referee's decision stands. The winner headlines Chris Michaels.
Tonight, my winning streak, it starts tonight. You know, my reigns might be a little bit crazy, but I do what I have to do to win, and that's what I'm here for, is to win. Let's do it, come on.
Oh, my God. tournament. Inside the ring, and in Las Vegas, Nevada, Ryder. And his tag team partner, hailing from Nashville, Tennessee, Dynamite Dan. And their opponents getting coming in by to the ring by Angel from Hell's Kitchen, New York. Locust, Ludacris, the New Devils.
I know you mean. I saw it written on the bathroom wall next to the phone number. But boys, be happy with your victory tonight. It'll be the last one for a while.
At least I have the right sex with me. It's gonna be a tag team championship final. Booty Paul versus the New Devil. That's for next week, y'all. And Booty Paul, if I were y'all, I'd be prepared. Protein bar that looks, no, that don't look like a broken rule. You might have to find something to build up the rule.
Thank you.
little problem here. Boyd is saying he doesn't have to defend against.
My attorney says I don't have to referee.
He does not have to do this in contract with Simon. This was not the contract. This is not.
Did I say he can have that? Am I working with that?
Yeah, you are. I'm going to tell you what. You won't be out here. Bulldog, you won't have to worry about this. Come here. Give me that hand. I'll take your hand out of here. You go. You get in there and don't you stick your face out here no more. Go. Get up. He's been out here all night interfering, and he's going to stay in the back. And this is going to be man to man until I say man to punk.
The following contest is the main event of the evening, and for the CWA Heavyweight Championship, inside the ring, hailing from Hell Creek, Mississippi, the CWA Heavyweight Champion, Boyd. Outside the ring, hailing from Atlanta, Georgia, Bulldog Reigns.
Oh!
Thank you.